I forgot to put the music on. Oh, balls. Social media must happen. Is anyone here yet? Nobody. No! No, there are... Whoa. There are people here. Hello! Hello, Driver! Hello, Vanguard! Hello, Coco Dico! Hello, Hey There Lol! Hello, RK Please! Hello, hello! Hello, Destroyer! Hello! Hello, hello! I don't know why you say goodbye. I should stop singing when the frickin' music is playing. Disable that, stream notifications, and stream now. Probably don't need to do that so often. Okay, so, now we do this, show the desktop, delete that, and where were we? We're here! I am a werewolf, thank you! How are you guys? Hello, Kwani King. Alright, what the hell is going on? Why is my stream manager being weird? It needs a friggin' other things to happen. Okay, Alright, so this is the I don't know what to build stream. So, from the very rough poll I did, just basically people seem to want something that's big and explodey. So, also there were multiple requests for pop-up turrets, like hidden turrets, so what do you think, guys? So, okay, we can try and build a battleship, but there's no guarantee I can finish that in 2 hours. But yeah, like, battleship with pop-up weapons? How's that? First, we need to design a pop-up turret. Shall we do crams and APS on this battleship? Yeah, hidden doom cram, I like that. I like that a lot. How do you do a hidden doom cram? How would you do that? I'm like, it requires a piston of some kind. And also... let's prototype that. Hidden spin doom cram. Okay, let's try that right now. Alright, so let's just build a doom cram quickly and see how we can hide it. You need a long barrel. Okay, I think I've got an idea. Hear me out, guys. Hear me out. So, okay, I've been doing this kind of build a lot recently. And I just like it's going to be kind of a pancake turret, but not really. So, let's see if this works. Alright. So, it's going to be a big fat thing. It's also going to be quite flat, so darn it. Alright, cool. We've got a plan. Hidden pop-up doomgram. I like that. I like that. Okay. And yeah, pop up every... I think actually... No, okay. Alright, so, plan. The plan is we're gonna have a doomgram, but it's gonna be essentially hidden in the hull, and like with a kind of bullpup design, so most of the barrel will be inside the turret cap, and then... As part of the superstructure, it will have spin blocks that kind of rise up and open up. Because I think it's a bit of a risk to put a big turret on a piston, because then if the piston gets destroyed, the whole thing falls off. So let's try this. And of course, what needs to happen first is that I need to build a doomcram. And I'm going to go with, I think, AP frag, because that works really well for doomcram. Wait, no! Let's be cute! Hello, Frostbite. Hello, Driver. Let's be cute, let's make it HEEMP, because, I don't know, as much as I love Doomcram Frag, I already know that works, so, actually, let's do this instead. Darn it. Okay, we've got a turret base. Crud. Let's not do that. Let's do this instead. Okay. So we got this. And And it's not going to be very tall. Like so. Yes, I know this thing could be even more circular. You don't need to tell me, I know. That's it, okay. Okay, this thing is going to be damn big. Alright, so let's see here. What kind of Tetris would work best here? Okay, so I finally got my... Let's go here. Let's see, does this fit nicely? No, it does not. So we're going to do this instead. This is going to be a single-barreled thing, by the way, because with big crams like this, it seems like you get much, much better results if it's just a single big cram cannon rather than... a bunch of smaller ones that are sharing pellets. At least for a lot of things. Maybe, no. No. Let's do two. Let's go somewhat battleshipy. We'll do two. I kind of want to do one. Let's see which one makes us happier. Okay. Because happiness is good. Yay. Okay. Alright, we've got one call for just do the single barrel cram cannon, so let's this, and let's fill this with pellets, and let's go, we've got two layers here, so let's do, alright, let's do a line of hardeners down the middle just for extra health, like, mainly this is just so it can get through LAM systems easily, because I still hate lambs. I actually don't hate lambs that much. Alright, so... And then we're gonna have HG pellets. Lower layer. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Let me know if you can hear or not hear the music, by the way, folks. There we go. Lots of HG pellets. Yay, cram cannons. Alright, this thing is huge already. Okay. Okay, I've, alright, one, alright, we'll do one. We'll do one barrel. We'll do one barrel.
Yay. Okay, people are trying to learn French now.
Yeah, it is a chonky cram slice. What was I doing? I was doing this, alright. And length. It's 22, 23. This is a 23 by 23 turret. This is a pretty big. All right, so now we go there. It's super flat, which is very convenient. So I'm just going to replace this layer with the EMP. Yes. I feel this is like, this might not be the most effective thing in the world, but it's gonna be pretty cool, I hope. There we go. Ah, soothing country music to build cram cannons to. Yay! Oh yeah, I should probably also mention that the music playing in the background, I got pretty much all of it from the YouTube audio library, so if you're wondering where these tracks come from, that's where they come from. Because hopefully I don't get sued for using them on Twitch. Probably should, like, put a master playlist somewhere on the internet so people can see that. There we go. Okay, so we've got that, and now, what I have gotten fond of doing now is, sticking more autoloaders on top here, because, you don't actually need... a lot of gauge increases anymore, so we can do fun things like this. And just just going to stick some payload compactors in here preemptively. There we go, just to get some extra pellets. Extra pellets. Some extra connections. Not quite free extra connections, but close. Alright, let's go. Where are we? Here, this is kind of improvised Tetris, which is why this is a thing. Now let's do that instead. Alright, chat is officially gone a little bit weird. Just a little bit weird. Ah, perfect. Alright, now let's just see if all these things are connected. Oh, you damn fool. Okay, yeah, they are connected. Groovy. Perfect. Actually, I should keep that firing piece just on there so I can see when things are connected. It's also good to see what the reload time on this thing is. Reload time is well, okay, that thing is 1,000 millimeters, so that's why that is. Let's do this now. How much expensive are autoloaders are fairly cheap. Autoloaders are fairly cheap. Come on, there we go. There we go. Lovely, lovely. And a few more over here? Question mark. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna save this fortress quickly as a placeholder. Yeah, we're going with explosions, because that is what the people seem to want. So, it's gonna go here. Alright, so this thing is like so. And this thing is gonna have quite a... no neck. This thing's not gonna have really have a neck. It's gonna go there. And this is not gonna be circular. It's gonna be very flat. If you hate flat designs, you will hate this. This thing is going to be kind of hard to hide because it's very big. Okay. Crap. Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do at all. Wait. Is that what I wanted to do? I usually do a double layer right there, yeah. Yep. Forgot to do that. Alright. No, this is gonna make the thing slightly taller. But yeah, with these necklace turrets, you do need an extra layer. Just to be safe. Make safe. What am I doing? We're building a Doomcram, which we're somehow going to hide with spin block stuff. This could be a disaster, but it's okay. Alright, now we can do the big fat turret cap. Okay. Tend to hide the gauge increases in the turret cap these days. I've come full circle when it comes to bad ideas. So just inertia. Let's do that. What is the AP on this thing? Alright, that's a fair amount. And now we're just going to 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Damn it. And ta-da! Reload time is 14 seconds. Let's get that to 20, because apparently that's roughly the best place for DPS. So I'm just going to replace some of the EMP pellets. Or the hardener pellets, rather. So 1, 2, what does that get us? 15! 16... 18, one more, should do it. Ta-da! Alright, so this thing does roughly 64,000 explosive damage and 70,000 EMP damage. We are gonna need to test fire this thing, clearly. Actually, let's finish the turret cap. What is chat talking about? Toast. Oh, sorry, I didn't see your question, Toast. How do you build a cram turret with different cram systems evenly share pellets? Just to quickly show you, the best way to do that is actually, to make a four-barreled cram turret something like this. And so you just basically have equal connections. So you start with this, and then you radiate symmetrically outward, like so. So if I do this, so just gonna go here, and you'll see that all of these guys have the same reload time. So So if you want evenly firing cram turrets, your best bet is to go with a four-barreled cram turret, because this is a game based around cubes. It's easiest to get things perfectly even and symmetrical that way. Or you can just mess around with here and with the minimum packing, although that's not evenly sharing pellets, so I guess not.
Okay.
You are welcome, Toast. Okay, chat is speaking French. They're speaking Le French. Okay, what was I doing? I was making magic happen. I hope. Alright, let's go. Let's narrow this quickly. There we go. So it's not unnecessarily chonk. Be there, be square. Actually, can this actually rotate around the whole deck? I sometimes forget to check this. And oh, balls. Nope, there's a gap left. Crap. Alright, well, we can't do that then. You can't have holes in your friggin' deck. So we're going to just increase this by one. There we go. There we go. Well, that's not as sleek as I liked, but oh well. Yep, the concealing this thing's gonna be kind of difficult. I'm basically gonna have to hide this thing inside really big superstructure. Which is probably good practice for me, because, me and superstructure historically have not gotten on that well. I mean, it's more like I keep forgetting that superstructures are a thing. Like, I've recently fallen back into old habits just when making things for fun. I just leave the superstructure off. Which is bad. Superstructure is actually kind of useful. I used to think, like way back in the day, I used to think of it as just something that was there to get shot off. And that's actually why it's useful. It's good for getting shot at. Oh, perfect. Hiding this thing is going to be very difficult. Okay. Is the damn battleship this thing's gonna be on? Can we even have more than one of these without my game lagging to pieces? Also, we've just doomed ourselves, cause hey. Very square turret. Very square. Oh no. Damn it! Oh, damn it, damn it, damn it. No wonder that wasn't working. I did it wrong. I did it wrong. There we go. 4 meter beams for life. It's getting to the point I've played so much from the depths and just play so many 4 meter beams that Did I just curse? What?
What? Did I swear?
I did not notice.
Okay. What?
Okay, what is happening? What is happening? Doomcram that we're somehow going to hide. This is looking less viable all the time in terms of hiding thing. I'm actually going to have to move this turret because it might clip on my control surfaces here. Okay, we do need to test fire this thing, because I suspect it's going to disintegrate stuff. And remember, we want this hidden, so the turret is going to... The barrel... Actually, hold on. Crap. There we go. And I don't know what's going to go in there, so I'm just going to stick surge protectors. Okay, so we go here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And just a whole bunch of heavy bone. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we've got a very snubby little barrel. God, that looks weird. But it's got to, well, I guess it's going to get hidden.
I can kind of beatbox Conmac the Barbarian. It's just the old.
That is just the boots and cats method. Alright, so. Jeez, that looks weird. This looks like a siege gun of some kind. So if we rotate that, is there a corner of the... Damn it! This is why I prefer the circular turrets. Also, we are catching on this. Screw it. Big fat... Do not like it, and the thing's big enough already.
Oh, boy. Oh, dear.
Alright, well, let's just fire at a marauder and see what happens. Quality King, like, what ep? Like, you mean the next campaign episode? Like, I don't know. I've been slightly demotivated lately, so... Is that going to hit anything? Yes, it is. See, the problem with HE Doomcrams is that they're always a little bit underwhelming because of that really hard cap on explosive radius. Admittedly, the... What's the reload on this thing? 20 seconds. Yeah, this is... it feels very underwhelming. It just feels underwhelming. Even though those very big numbers... Very big numbers. Oh, we're at 19 second reload time. Okay, and we missed. That's nice.
Get the armor of the turret.
All right. Oh my word. Okay. Let's actually have you on decent tracking thing. Wait, what was that? Oh, Ep as in album, alright. Whoops. I don't know. It's one of those things that's just perpetual on the back burner, but I do... Back burner. How about we test something that isn't just a hollow brick of wood? What happens if we fire at, I don't know, a bulwark like this? At the very least, we should be able to get through the lambs on here. Actually, we should test the iron cordon. That's good, but... Just frag at this level is so much better! You know what? What would happen if we just got rid of the EMP? We just got rid of it. What? Come on now. All right, that'll do. Wow, people are just learning languages in chat. People are just learning languages. Alright, so now we've got 100,000 explosive damage. Does this actually create the right block confetti for how big and fat this turret is? Well, not if it whiffs entirely. Not if it whiffs entirely. That does make things harder. Actually, I've got an idea, guys. I've got an idea. It's basically putting hidden weapons, but it's not where you think it is. Because that big turret is too big to hide. Did we explode things? It's not a... Alright, let me demonstrate the difference. Because I think that's worth talking about. So you set that to frag, and you'll see that it does considerably more damage. Yeah, actually, Kualani, that is my plan. I'm actually planning to hide pop-up guns in the turret. Yeah. I know it's a deviation from the plan, but it also means that we can make this thing way more accurate. That actually kind of looks like a turret now, as opposed to a not turret. So this thing does about 100,000 damage per fragment, of which it's got 46. So let's see now. The plan was to have a hidden Doomcram. This Doomcram is too big to hide, so unless I redo the turret gap and, like, you know, don't... Okay. So, this is what Doomfrag does. So it's like, it's unlike the HE, it has knocked off 2% health immediately and has kind of poked holes, like, straight through the superstructure. And what else has it done? Yeah, it's just gone everywhere and made a mess. So yeah, just Doomfrag works so much better because it's like an explosion but with a much bigger radius. So yeah, and it fires again. Where's that? Yep, so we've gone in and we've tickled multiple important things. See, that's the difference. Frags get in to places. Let's just see if, since we've got this big turret cap, let's just hide things in it. Yeah, I'm just gonna roll with this. I know explosions were what we wanted, but... Right, let's see here. How much space do we have in here? Let's just do this for the sake of convenience. So, what kind of things can we hide in here? Ow! That's loud.
Where are you? Get out of here. Get out of here. Remove from list. There we go.
Alright, so what kind of pop-up stuff can we have? Let us stick some pop-up stuff. Here. We can do pop-up missiles back here. Yeah, let's do pop-up missiles first because that's fun. Clever and do this. Add the missile controller back here, use wireless connections. Let's do small missiles for giggles. Small gantry. Nice. So, and let's see if this works. So we've got the ACB over here. When enemy around. Oh yeah, we need one of these. We definitely need one of these. Okay, so enemy within 3,000 meters, set spin blocks to, where is it, spin blocks, search pattern, missile, hidden missiles, what the, off. I spawn in, I don't know, a bastion, for instance. That does not appear to be working. Alright. Durr, it's because I didn't name the spin block. A durr, 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 durr. A durr. Okay.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so now let's set that to... That should be 30 degrees. 30 degrees, 30 degrees. That's kind of ugly, but... So how does that look? Okay, so now we need to set this. So that is 0. Not 0. What the hell? What is... Oh, it's because... it's because of the slopes. Durr. Durr, 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 durr. There, no one would suspect a thing. Now let's see if this thing fires without... Wait, no, let's put a failsafe on this. Might need it. There we go. Let's see here. Bastion. Huh. That actually kind of worked. Now let's make these explodey things. Let's make him cruise myself that explode. Here, yes, please. I actually kind of like that. Yep, power of Doomcrag. Actually, how much HE damage do these things do? I was not paying attention. Oh! Not bad for small missiles. Alright, see you, Quali. Yeah, exactly, Otto. Doom, go bonk. Groovy, alright. Alright, let's see if this works the way it was intended to. Let's spawn in Sebastian again. Oh, I didn't name the damn thing. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Are these things well hidden? I mean, they could be better well hidden, I guess. No one would suspect a thing, alright. Oops! Forgot about that. Cool. Oh, I like it. Yay, constant rain of missiles. Constant rain. Frostbite, no, I've not looked at the blueprints yet. I've been a bad boy. Wait, no, which blueprints were these? I honestly don't remember. Was that the mass driver thing? No, was that someone else? I think there are slightly too many people sending me stuff. And I appreciate it, but at the same time, like, I keep doing that thing where it's like, oh, I'll look at this later, and then I don't. So, please don't take that personally. Yeah, Conwerk, I don't know why I don't do that. I don't know, I kind of like this. Alright, so there's those pop-up missiles. I'm just gonna leave that as, excuse me, what's going on? Excuse me. There we go. Save this thing. Placeholder. We need some pop-up. You know what we need? We need some pop-up machine guns. Actually, there's a cunning thing I was doing before. How cunning is this, do you ask? I'm glad you asked, because it's oh so cunning. How big is this piston? Kinda damn big. Don't care for that. Wait. Yes, Equizzle, I have used the radar thing. I don't want to spoil what I've used it on, because I should upload that video soon-ish. But yeah, I have used it to great effect. Or mediocre effect. Yeah, that frostbite, yeah, I did look at it and was like, ugh, I can't understand this. Also, I was like, I cannot understand this yet. Cannot compute. The hell is that noise outside? Alright, how am I gonna... This turret is actually kind of flat, so what can I hide in here? What can I even hide in here? Wait. I'm thinking about this all wrong. Why don't we have things popping out the side? What can we pop out the side here, do you think? Frostbite, I couldn't figure out how to shoot it at something. Didn't look at it long enough to figure that out. Talking about the mass driver that Frostbite sent me. Okay. I cannot brain. What the hell is this? Okay. Hidden weapons are hard. Would this be cheating? Do you think? Okay, just want to test something quickly. Very, very quickly. Oh! That does work. Hello. That does work. Interesting. Alright. Alright. Now I know. Wait, does that work on a piston, though? Does that work on a piston? Oh, I could have. Damn it. I could have done that the whole time. Never mind. Back to what I actually wanted to do. L to load to Odafar. Okay, thank you, Frostbite. Actually, yeah, particle cannon that pops up on a piston. Yes. Or APS that pops up on a piston. Actually, but guys, hear me out. Simple weapon. Let's try the simple weapon first, because I know how to make that work with crams. Because I'm a genius. Genius. Then we're going to have this guy. And then we are going to cunningly cover that in decorations. So if we pop that up by 3 meters. Or 2 meters. Oh, hell yeah, guys. Go, where's it? Condition, blah, and move across drones, pistons. Enemy within 3,000 meters, extend piston by 2 meters. Could just cover it like this. I could. Does that still work? I think it just clips a lot. Nope, that does not work. Wait, no. Oh, it's because the... it's because I named it. I keep naming these things and forgetting that I named them. Stop naming things. Stop it. Or I could... hidden guns. There we go.
Okay.
Let's go here. Hidden guns. Let's see if this works. If this does clip out, I don't know. I don't know. Surprise, fool! Nice! Okay, does that look weird, guys? Ikwurzel, did I ever use that? I think I did try at one point. It is usually easier just to have it as a, like, an odd width. Talked about the even width thing. I have made an aircraft like that. I don't think it was successful, but not because it was even width. It was just not a good design. Okay, let's actually have... Alright, so this is how you get simple weapons like this to work with crams. You just gotta make sure that they fire shells that are roughly the same velocity as cram shells. So, go here... And this is a 150mm gun. Just gotta double check how what's the maximum. Shell length is 1.8, so... So we go here, and let's just have them be full HE, because that's fun. 1, and 3, and 1, let's go one more. That's a little bit too long. Alright. Yes! Perfect. Yes! Alright, let's go here. Inertial fuse, and then just a butt ton of these. And, ooh, almost perfect. Yes! Exactly 200 meters per second. Still got decent range. And does some of that. Yes. Thank you. We'll do that.
Alright. Oh, yeah.
I can just... You're absolutely right. I can totally... I can just put a hat on the thing. Like what I did with the first thing. Let's go here. Watch this. Watch this. Crap. What was that? Yes. What? Oh. I'm having fun. Nope, damn it. Go here. Here. Right, so now we do this. Oh, hell yeah, guys. Oh, I like this. I like this. Are these things actually hitting, though? is the question. They actually are, kind of. They did! Let's make them hash, because that's probably actually gonna work a lot better. Oh, hello, alright, let's just make them hash. Let's just make him hash. Also, let's tilt those missiles up a little bit more, because otherwise, I'm afeard of things. Yeah, those whiffed a lot. But it's okay. Are they not controlled by AI? Oh, do you think so? Nah, we're good. We're all good in the neighborhood. Yeah, I think these things need their own local weapon controllers. Yeah, because otherwise they are gonna miss. At which point... Let's see here... How to make this work? Make this work. Do something like this, and the thing will actually do what I want it to. And priority is, where's the priority? Well, it's gonna set the priority to that to zero. Save that as placeholder. Go over here and place that right. No, you fool! Wait, did those actually get anywhere near the target? They did, kind of. Okay, that's better. There we go. Look at this weird thing. Oh wait, missiles aren't firing? What? No, I didn't turn them off. What's happening there? Oh, I think it's... okay, I think... There we go, let's see if that changes things. There you go, it was the required accuracy. The launch pads were tilted too far away. There we go. This is a fun thing. I like this. Yay. Yeah, the Versafes can work. You just gotta be aware of them, I guess. Yeah, I like this. Oh, I like this. I mean, there's gaps in the friggin'... Wait a minute. You know what we should do? We can stick a timed fuse on this. Fuse on this bad boy. Lovely. Alright, guys, we are cooking with charcoal.
Mmm. It would. Well. You make up a map.
Oh, yeah, alright. Yeah. Okay, guys, we can make this thing look pretty. Let's see. How. Mantlet. Let's go. Here, and I'm gonna start with the rubber thing. And right there. Purple. Okay, we're gonna drop the height of that by one. All right, up and down positioning minus one. Let's go. That's a mantlet of sorts. On a scale of 1 to Garbo, how does that look, lads?
Add a particle cannon to the side.
Itchwurz, if you, I don't know, a few updates ago, decorations were added, so they're like mimics, but you can put them on any block, so you just go on any block, hit Control X, and it brings up, this, menu. Right here. So you don't actually need to... you don't actually need mimics anymore if you don't want them. Mostly mimics are useful for prefabbing decorations, because you can do... Here's a mimic. So you go here, and you go here, and you can change the decoration. And then you just shift the tether point of that down, and then, yeah. That's how you do.
Okay. Hello. Okay.
All right. Okay. We need a kind of a better mantlet for this, or at least we need to smooth this out. So I'm going to do. Another mantlet over here. So we're gonna do this. Did not work as I hoped it would. Okay, now delete that. Let's mess with this. Just a little bit. Where? Oh, there. I found it. All right, so left, right, scale. Let's do that. And just make something like this. How's that look? Down positioning. Okay, I'm happy with that.
Yep.
Oh, thank you, Bright Lego. Like, I don't know, sometimes I make a good thing. It's been an hour and we've just made the turret of whatever the hell we're doing. Somebody mentioned particle cannons on the side, so... yeah, we should do that. Yeah, let's try that. How do we do that, though? Don't want unarmored particle cannons, because that doesn't seem smart. Could just lever them out like... Hold on, I'm using my brain. This turret's so big it might just have the one main turret and then a whole bunch of secondaries. Okay. Particle cannons might be kind of hard to do on this thing. Think. BorderWise is engaging brain. I mean, if they're completely unarmored, right? So we got a 3x3 space. We got a. Wait a minute. We could put them in the front. Could be like this. Is using decorations to hide things not in the spirit of what we're doing? Bright Lego, that's not exactly the definition of Doom Crams I roll with. But yeah, like, no. Like, I don't know, the term Doom Cram is quite, I don't know, it's quite a fuzzy and, like, vague one, but it's any just, it's basically any cram cannon that's just a really big, and, like, where that a regular Doom, like, where a regular cram cannon becomes a Doom Cram is actually kind of vague, so, I don't know, I can't say you're wrong, but... like, they don't get less doomy when you have more of them. Quite the opposite. Alright, okay. Alright, you know what? Let's do that. We're just going to have, we're going to hide some particle cannons on turrets inside here. So... what the... Oh, I was freaking out there for a second. I was like, what the hell is that? Okay, let's do that. This, there's going to be a decoration right here, and we'll just mark it like so. And particle cannons. And I'm actually going to stick these on a turret. So, a locked turret. So, let's go here. Elevation only turret. Done it. Let's go here. I'm going to stick a local weapon controller just behind this. Okay, and priority is that. Let's go here. What's over here? It's being aimed. That's lovely. It's going to be very teeny tiny. We could put three of them on here, actually. Yes, we can. We can. We're going to. That's not going to work. You know what will work, though, is this. Crap, okay. These are not going to be very powerful particle cannons. Very triumphant music to go with this, though. This turret is going to be so jammed full of stuff, it's going to be kind of fragile. Why the extra... Otto, yeah, I should explain that. The extra turret is just so I don't have to put a local weapon controller, like, up near the pack lens itself. So, that's just... It's a little handy trick for... of firing these things, although I guess I could try to fire it with ACBs, but that is going to require a lot of fiddling about. And I just remembered I'm going to need batteries for this. That's too far. Back it up. There we go. And we're going to set these to explosive because that's fun. Go, and we're just going to do decoration, metal slug. Wait, no. Yes, it was. You can look at the last Weird and Wonderful I did with the great filter. It is entirely possible. Excuse me. It is entirely possible to make a thing that is controlled and fired entirely with ACBs. Bright Lego. Is it better to have, packs of the closed loop with the one, or like the ones that you have for big packs? Not sure. Oh, the closed loop, so if you're meaning the particle input port, that reduces damage loss at range, so that's better if you're using a long-range particle cannon. So if you're, the main weaponry on your craft is a pack, yeah, this is kind of better than the Terminator. We're using the Terminator here because I'm, quite frankly, being lazy. Wait, no, it's metal sub. There we go, and down 2 meters, perfect. And width. Perfect. Perfect. And we just need quickly this thing. Gonna place some stuff here. So this is actually an engine I developed for testing rail guns, but it works to power particle guns as well. We need batteries. There we go. Righty here then. You know what's a really good idea? You know what's a really good idea? Mirror mode. How much damage does this do? Not a hell of a lot. We're gonna need a lot more engines for this.
Oh boy.
This is a turret with many hidden weapons on it. And I hate steam engines at the moment, so we're just gonna keep adding these injector things until we get enough juice to power those particle cannons. Well, let's test it. This thing might shoot itself slightly. Wait, no. Let's do this. Because I want those particle cannons to fire. So we go here, spawn this. Music? There we go. A pack equals particle cannon. Oh my goodness, guys. Do those particle cannons actually hit? I did not see that. In about 10 seconds, they're gonna fire again. And we have enough juice for them. That's great. Oh my goodness, it's working! Oh, I actually quite like this turret. This is so silly. I'm gonna need to adjust the fail-safes on the simple weapons, though. Guys, we've made something workable and cool.
Yay!
Nah. Coco the cat, the particle cannons will have not a huge amount of trouble because they've got a decent field of fire. So, yeah, I'm not too worried. We can test it. First, I'm just gonna do this. Also, I'm gonna crack open my emergency caffeine, because that's a good idea. Yum! Okay, where were we? Let's test it against something reasonably quick that you need to lead. So, Steel Striders, what was I shooting at the other day? Reef Shark. This thing actually motors along kinda quickly. Because it's a hydrophile skimmer, baby! It's also got a lot of lambs on it. So let's see if the particle... Yeah, I don't think the particle cannons are gonna have any trouble. Also, it's gonna collide with us, and that's, not your best move, mate? Huh. We appear to be stuck. Oh yeah, we're stuck on something. Ah, I missed the particle cannons firing. Excuse me? Alright, let's see. Particle cannon's going to hit. Are they gonna do anything? Oh, hello. Doomcram just removed a turret and broke its physics. Cool.
Love it.
Mm-hmm. I'm drinking a Coke Zero, right, Lego? I spawned this in just to test, something the other day, and yeah, the Reef Shark is ridiculous. It is fast. It is a fast boy. It is also, like, yeah, this thing goes 80 meters per second with propellers. Yeah, it's crazy. Also, it's zapping that Doomcram out of the air, and I don't like it. Really don't care for that. Yeah, kind of annoying, actually. Damn it. Like, yeah, this thing almost deserves a Most Wanted, simply because it's like, this is the Steel Strider's answer to those Lightning Hood's hydrofoil craft. So that's annoying.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, the lamp system on that is kind of redinky-dink. Alright, so we try, we've got about half an hour of stream time left. Shall we try making a hull for this thing to sit on? Because I think I have an idea of what to do for it. It's not going to be the most damage-proof hull, to be perfectly honest with you. Actually, I should armor this thing's internals a little bit before I do anything else. Which basically means this. Or I can use ducts. Ducts. I can use ducts, guys. Quack. Because these things are perfect space armor. Yay, does that all work? No, don't do that. Cool, now let's see if that works.
That was super lazy.
Yeah. Basically, ducts are perfect spaced armor because heat and hesh trigger immediately upon contacting them, so I don't know, they're not, it's an exaggeration to say that they're perfect, but they're a lot better than empty space, and I think they're actually better than oblique panels. I think. I've never actually used stuck ducts in a turret cap like this before, but I don't know, it's just an easy way of getting extra armor in there. Right, so done that. Let's just check that everything works. Let's shoot at an Excalibur. Yeah, I think this thing just shot itself slightly. Oh, you dummy. Ooh, Whoa. Excalibur is pretty cool, not gonna lie. Maybe it's the I think it might be the time fuse that's, wait a minute, I just want to test something quickly. Let's do that, and let's spawn in. Save that as placeholder, yeah. Yeah, a lot of people actually were pointing out to me in the last armor tutorial I did that ducts stopping heat and ash actually makes sense because real-life armored vehicles have that kind of mesh armor for precisely that reason. Where's the reshock again? I want to see if the cram can actually hit it now that the time fuse isn't actually stupid. It is going to collide with us, though, because, you know, that's what it does. Oh, that's so much better. I keep forgetting how timed fuses can screw me. Yep, we just ruined its lamb system slightly. Just slightly, a little bit. A teensy tad. That's because this is why, people, even if your craft is really fast, don't get close to cram cannons. Because they will hurt you. They will hurt you directly in your feelings. Unless they miss. Although that lamb system appears to have run... Okay, it has not run out of juice. Maybe I should swap out... The HE on the packs for impact or something. Come on, fire that big Doomcram, you know you want to. Meow. Damn it! You know what we could do? Just try and make this actually work. Aim for clusters of blocks, thank you. Oh, hello, that trimmed something off. Oh, it trimmed railings off. We can beat this thing with this turret. I know we can. Okay, see you, right, Lego. Oh, I completely missed that. I looked away and we just doom crammed it right in the face. What the hell did we do? Oh, this thing uses rudders. It doesn't use hydrofoils. Oh, yeah, cheeky sod. This is fun. I'm having fun. Yes! Ouch! That looked like it stung a bit. We just took out one of its steam engines. Oh, Doomfrag. Doomfrag. Oh, how I love thee. Like, I hope you guys don't mind me just sitting here and watching this a bit, because I feel good now. Lucini Asio 007. Rudders are actually far more powerful than hydrofoils when it comes to control surfaces for your ships. You do have to mess with them a little bit. They're a little bit more complicated. Ouch. And this is why I like Doomfrag, ladies and gentlemen. It just works really well. It gets right in there. It digs holes deep. Oh. Look at that! Even the APS shells are getting... Oh, we just knocked out the steam engines. Oh, hello, sitting duck. Quack, quack. We missed.
yeah.
Yeah, yeah, exactly what Coco the Cat says. Rudders scale with mass rather than speed, so they work on very big things. Actually, you know what I might do for this? Actually, no, I'm not gonna do that. Keep it as it is. How redundant is that LAM system that it can keep firing even after the engine power is gone? Jeez. Yeah, they are pretty. They are very, very pretty. They're also quite fun to shoot at, assuming you finally built something that can shoot at them effectively. This thing farts out so many torpedoes, it's a little bit irritating, not gonna lie. Oh, we took out one of its propellers. Come on. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Few more shots. Right in the guts of the thing.
Yay.
The particle cannons just missed. Actually, yeah, I want to try something. Actually, I'm going to try that again. But, and this is a big stinky butt, I'm gonna get rid of that time fuse because, it seems to, I don't know, I learned the hard way the one time I entered a tournament is that, alright, let's see here, I'm just gonna set this to 23 degrees, that still does a lot of damage, so, let's try that, let's try penetrator, so, because we can hit the thing, can confirm. That one's gonna miss, though. Yeah, see, that's what, yep, what do we take off there? We appeared to, where did we hit? Oh. What the hell, where? Oh, where? Where did we hit the thing? Here? Oh yeah, we did. Let's see if this does it any quicker. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. What did that do? I can't even see where these things are landing. Oh, right here. Oh. Oh, hello. Yep, oh, hello. Here's an AI compartment. Yeah, I'm gonna swap out those bottle cannons for something else. Or not yet. Come on, Doomcram, do your thing again. Do your thing again, you know you want to. So many torpedoes. That's guys, that's excessive. You missed!
Why?
Twinkie Octopus, short answer is no, they are not better than APS. Just overall, basically there's nothing a cram cannon can do that an APS can't conceivably do better. It's just that APS is a bit more complicated to learn than cram cannons. Damn it. So that's the problem with penetrator frag again, is that they do miss. When they miss... Well, this is a good example of why APS is overall better than cram. It's like, this is a very powerful cram cannon. Like, this is very strong, but muzzle velocity of only 200 meters per second. As soon as something is moving above 40 meters per second, or it's at a distance, or anything like that. Although, yeah, when it does hit, it's very satisfying. Although, it keeps to hitting in a very annoyingly awkward location. Come on. Don't make me take manual control. Yeah, those pothole cannons are really not doing much. Although we do appear to be blowing holes clean through this whole craft. That is nice. Oh no, Otto has started singing. Uh-oh. Did we just crash? No, we didn't. The main reason APS is better than CRAM, and I say this as a CRAM fan, is that APS is just way more versatile. It's just, you can have it do almost anything. You can have it for anti-air, you can have it shoot submarines, you can have it as secondary or primary weapons, you can have it shoot at slow things, fast things, you know, erratic things. Just, it's got like three different, four different anti-armor options. So you've got AP, you've just got regular AP, you've got HESH, you've got heat, you've got hollow point, and you've got rail guns, which basically makes them even better again. So, and just CRAM is just not as versatile. It's just nowhere near as versatile. It's only good against slow, against things that are big or slow, or move in predictable movement patterns. And past a certain point in the game, past a certain difficulty level, there's basically nothing that fits that. I mean, look, this isn't even a godly Steel Strider's craft. This is this is a medium one. And we can barely hit it. And it's right in our faces. Yes, Coco, I have tried rams. I made a piston ram video sometime ago. Let's change this from this to this. Will we get better results if we spread the frags out a little bit? I think this Doom Cram needs to be slightly more doomy in order for what I'm doing to work. Well, bugger. Nothing quite like testing it against, I'm gonna put that timed fuse back. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm gonna switch back to this, because this is kind of fun. I'm gonna do this. Switch this back to something. Yeah, that's not much damage at all, so I'm gonna switch this to impact again. Beam color, set to this. Placeholder. I don't think we're gonna get around to doing the hull, guys. Just a thought.
Yep.
Otto is just gone nuts in chat with singing.
Yeah, that's a good point, Pokerface.
I would argue that cram mortars are. I'm not a huge fan of them. They're like all the regular weaknesses of CRAM, but magnified, because they are really terrible against anything that's moving remotely quickly or erratically, or anything that's changing its altitude constantly. So the vast majority of things that are actually going to come and try and ruin your day when playing a campaign in From the Depths Cram mortars are even worse against them than, like, regular crams, so... Yeah, like, it really would be nice if the devs added something to cram cannons, just not to make them stronger, because they're actually pretty strong in terms of raw damage, but just make them more versatile, make them more useful against a wider variety of things, because every other weapon system has that versatility. Like APS, you can use it for almost anything. Missiles, you can use them for almost anything. Particle cannons, you can use them for actually everything, and lasers are just anything that's above water, it's got it. Anything that's below water, no. So they've got a kind of specialist niche, but they do it better than anything else, so there's a reason for them. And simple weapons are simple. And the custom shell simple weapons, like, they are as versatile as APS, almost, so...
Yeah. Yeah, da-da-da-da-da.
So, yeah. Like, I don't know. I'm just an old, bitter cram gunner. Thinking old, bitter cram gunner thoughts. Also, I forgot what I was doing. Well, we've got hidden weapons. I guess we can start building the hull of this just while we're here. This turret is 88,000 materials, so I think I'm gonna not build a canoe hull for this guy, because I'm gonna go with a more modern hull, so... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, okay. So we gotta do this. So we're gonna go with actually quite a modern ship hull for this, so it is going to be way more volume efficient than what I usually do. Yeah, half the time I end up designing turrets like this, I kind of don't get around to building the rest of the thing, because it's just, you know, you build a turret. For giggles! Wait a minute, didn't actually need to do that. Let's shorten this just a little bit, doesn't need to be this long. There we go. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. So, we're gonna use the winner chicken dinner spaced armor of legend. Damn it. No. Let's keep it like that. Let's keep it like that. There. Durr. Let's do this. Yep. Not what I wanted! It's not what I wanted at all. No. We need consistency. This is gonna be a very flat boat. Small caliber APS. What shell type is good for that? Heat is pretty good. Frag is okay. And kinetics are probably the best. So, especially if you have a small caliber railgun. Yeah, even just like an 18mm gun, if you pack enough rail juice into it and enough sabot warheads, can actually be pretty darn good. Right, I don't think I'm going to... What do we want here? We want 3 meters of alloy. For this, yes. Yes. Crap, nope, don't do that. this. Nope, not yet. Here, there we go. Oh yeah, baby, this is gonna float. It's also gonna have a lot of alloy on it. Okay, what's chat saying? The alloy is effectively going to act as a spool liner. Because the internal citadel is going to be armored in metal. So, I tend to do that. It seems to work reasonably well. Reasonably well. Not perfect. Also, there's going to be multiple layers of this. So, Hesh is not going to be as much of an issue. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. So, we're going to go here. 1, 2, 3. 3 meter air gap. Yes. Okay, good, good, good. This is weird. This is an incredibly flat craft. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. This is not gonna be a serious thing. Oh boy. I need to get my ass in the tournament so I remember how to build things properly. Righty-ho then, there we go. Okay, so now we have basic dimensions, and now we're going to put the pointy bit on. The pointy bits. So, let's do this. There we go, not canoe shaped at all. Face. I am building this because basically for giggles, and also because this is, I guess, what chat ended up suggesting is just something with hidden weapons. This is a combination of a bunch of suggestions, because a lot of people suggested like hidden weapons, so This is a big cram turret with hidden weapons on it. And that's it. And I'm building the hull for this thing just to kind of see where it goes. This thing isn't going to work very well, to be perfectly honest with you, because that turret is full of fragile exploding things. With this rounded thing, because if I'd done my usual canoe thing, oh boy, this thing would be too big. It does. I think I need to get Twitch, what's it called again? Twitch validated? No, Twitch verified, in order to have custom emojis, on this, so... Yeah, that's gonna be hard. Alright, where does the transition happen? Is happening. Coco the cat. Is there ever going to be an aesthetic build? Probably. Eventually. Like, it'd be disappointing at this point if I tried and do a pure aesthetic build because I do not have the right mindset for that. Like, if I want to be flattering of myself, I would say that I'm a practical man. But if I'm being perfectly honest, I'm a creative person, but not an artsy person, I guess? I don't like things which are pretty but useless. So, yeah, I am a real joy to have in an art gallery. But yeah, I will try an aesthetic build. Like, actually, that's a good idea for next week's stream. I just try and make a pretty thing. Thank you! That is a good stream idea. I like that. I am now officially chilling. I am chilling so hard, guys. Guys, you don't even know. Chilling so hard. Exactly, Saber Jockey. I'm just a simple man trying to make my way in a in a world full of doom railguns and stuff. Alrighty, we're doing something. Not sure what we're doing yet, but we're doing it. Biomecha Man, what is this thing? This is the beginnings of a ship which main turret has hidden weapons on it. That's basically it. And let's see here. Let's just do this. Yeah, I need to. Actually, this is good practice for. I really need to do a how to build big video, because one of the keys to building big is to make things wider. Basically, I don't know, it's like, you gotta make things wider before taller or longer, and that's better for big things, I tend to find. And yes, my usual canoe shape doesn't do well with that. Okay. Yay, hull building is fun. It's so fun. Fun. Soothing, relaxing. I feel the worries of life melting away. Yep, Monster Kicker, I'm trying to deliberately avoid the whole canoe thing. Yeah, this thing's only 64 meters long so far. Usually, when I've built half the hull, the thing's over 100 meters long already. So, yeah, not a canoe. Deliberately trying to not be a canoe this time. It's not a bad-looking bow, actually. Not bad at all. Do. are we doing for time? Oh, jeez. Okay, so the plan is I need to finish this hull, and then I guess I'll have to stop. I'll probably have to stop. I have no idea how long this will take. This is already quite chonk. This is a very chonk ship. Actually, I can't see what I'm doing there, so I'm gonna do it the other way. There we go. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. Lovely, lovely. Blocks are falling into place. This is Tetris as hell! Pew, 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 pew! Cue air horns. Or cue that music. The Star Song. I forget how it's. The Star Song is very narrow for something that is, that's as big as it is. Yeah, what, how wide is the salsa? Hang on, I'm just going to quickly save this as... Doo-doo-doo. Save the vehicle, please don't crash. Okay, ships. Prototypes. Hidden... Weapons... Turret... thing. There we go. Alright, you hang there for a moment, and we're going to how big... Presumably you're meaning the Star Song Mark II. So we're gonna go over here. How wide is this thing? Not super wide. Oh, bless you, you beautiful thing. Alright, so yeah, the width is 29 meters long. Length of 311, so yeah, she's a long, skinny gal. Not the most efficient hull design, I will freely admit. Wow, this thing floats. Well, almost. It almost floats. Okay, let's see, what are we missing here? Ah, yes! Internal decking and stuff. How many blocks is this? 5,000. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this is... It's actually gonna be kinda hard to fit engines in here. Boy. Boy. I've done it again, lads. My things are too flat. Serve me right. Also, this thing is gonna have superstructure. Don't worry. Ship, no prototypes. Nah, prototypes. There we go. Yeah, it's like battleships are wide. Like, you look at schematics of real-life battleships. They're wide things. They're quite chunky. Hang on a minute. Yeah, okay, we don't want that. Let's go over here. And how wide do we want this thing? Length of 64. 64 divided by... 4 is 12. Let's do that to start off with. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And let's do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Alright. Okay, that's about as wide as we... Hang on. I'm just picturing this in my head. I'm picturing this in my head. Okay, let's do one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. Alright. Right. We can muck about later. Alright. Ta-da! That's about as long as this thing needs to be. Now we are going to abuse the hell out of the fill tool. And by abuse, I mean use efficiently. That's what I mean. Okay, then. Let's do that, and I'm probably going to have to... things as well. Let's see here. Ah, crap. How did we live without the undo tool and the fill tool working with mirror mode? How did we do anything before those glorious days? Biomarker, there is kind of spall liner or damn it! This is... You distracted me, Chad. Anyway, so there is kind of spall liner. You'll see it's metal alloy. It's not the best. I will freely admit this is not the best. And, ooh, crap, I need to do something in here. Yeah. Honestly, unless you're facing, like, really strong hair shells, a lot of the time you can get away with just having big air gaps. That does help a lot. So, yeah, there's no real spool. Wait a minute. Ah, crap, you're right. Crap! Crappity, crappity, crappity. There we go, there we go. There's kind of a spool liner, but more importantly, buoyancy. Okay, so, yeah, this is kind of half-assed spall liner. Frankly, because I don't feel like doing that right now. Okay. Probably gonna have to replace that with wood if... I don't know. If in a combat test this thing suffers greatly... Gosh, darn it. Okay. Okay, let's do this. This is why with big builds it helps to really, you know, think ahead of time. This thing is huge. It just occurred to me this thing is huge. We have not built most of the hull yet, and it's already 7,000 blocks. Now, I'm gonna scroll over here for a hot second. Damn it. Oh, this is why kinda I hate building big things, is because... Also, honey, can you please go somewhere else for a hot second? Because you're kind of distracting me. Alright, where was I? I was over here. Nope, I'm going to... the plan with this ship, assuming it ever gets finished, which it might not, is going to have this big turret up in the front here. And similar to... And then it's going to have just a whole... mass of secondaries in the back, like an unhealthy amount of miniguns just on the back as secondary guns. A lot of which are going to be hidden, so I don't know whether people, or I don't know whether I'm ever going to finish this thing or even continue working on it, but like, you know, that could be fun, the hidden weapon thing. And now we're at 9,000 blocks. It's a very flat thing. Super flat. Okay. So now we gotta do this thing. Super flat. Ooh, this thing's flat. Oh yeah, that's a good point, Cyber Jockey. We could do just internal custom jet engines for power. Look how flat this thing is! This is the flattest thing I've ever seen! And I'm gonna need to redo the backside of this thing anyway. Just to, like, you know, to have a pretty buttocks on it. Have a pretty buttocks. I can word. This is why my streams tend to be like roughly 2 hours long, because around the 2 hour mark is when my brain just decides, you know what, I've had enough of you. I'm going on strike. There we go, man. Whoop. And alright, now let's pretty this thing's bum a little bit. Just a little bit. Slightly rounded buttocks. Right. Yes. And there's gonna be something over here. This kind of... What is this called again? I think it's called a fantail. Just, you know, the bit of the ship that kind of hangs over the water like this. I think. I'm not sure. I could be wrong. I'm often wrong. People think, BorderWise, you're right all the time, and I'm like, no! Also, who are you and what are you doing in my house? The fact that, I do like how this thing floats, though. It floats like a dream. There we go. There we go. I've been saying there we go a lot. There we go. Also, here we go. This is the world's flattest thing. Ooh. Ooh, guys, are you seeing how flat this is? So flat. This is like a block of flats, but it's not flats, it's a ship.
Oh, I go. Custom jets and...
Yeah, custom jets, Ichwers, are amazing. Like, can't get enough of them, actually.
It's a me.
Azipod. And Azipod is basically... let's show you an example that I've got. Where's it? Some logs. An Azipod is something like this. It's propellers on... in terms of from the depths, it's propellers on a spin block that the spin block turns, and the thing is propulsion and steering all in one. So, very useful. Never leave home without them. They're way better than rudders, as far as I'm concerned. I mean, they do have their limits, but, yeah, not much. Alright, so the... Oh, for crying out loud. Did I goof? Guys, I think I goofed. Also, I keep forgetting which end is the middle of this thing. Damn it. Oh, for crying out loud. Okay, yes, that's kind of the basic hull. Hey, does this look like a canoe? Shift N for what? Why has... What are you talking about? Shift N for middle mirror. That does... No! Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Oh, know where you live, I does. I don't know where you live. Don't take that seriously.
Okay. Okay.
Hmm. Yay, we've been promoted from, We've been promoted from canoes to ironing board. You know what? I'll take it. Okay, yes. Yes, we are doing superstructure. Shock horror.
BorderWise doing superstructure.
Alt N? What? Nope. Alt N does nothing. Chat is such a blessing and a curse. Don't take that personally, please. So we've got a big superstructure right here. Nah, let's do that. Okay, now let's do this. Alright.
Alt N or Control N?
Alright, so let's do. Alright, Control N. What does that do? That does nothing. That does nothing. Nope, that does. Guys. Guys. Does nothing. Coco the cat, don't you tell me how to superstructure. Everyone's got their own ideas how to superstructure. What is it? What? How do you superstructure? Tell me how you superstructure, so I may laugh at you. Yeah, I'm just mucking around now. You might have noticed.
Yep. Layers. Layers, levels, and walkways. Ah, pfft.
You're one of those aesthetic builders. One of those aesthetic builders. A superstructure is not pretty. A superstructure is not pretty. A superstructure is a box to hide lamb's nodes in. Couldn't even say that with a straight face. It's also a place to hide chairs in. Okay, I'm gonna finish off this superstructure, and then, you know what? I should do. Because there's no way I'm gonna finish this. There's no way I'm gonna finish this today. No way, Jose. Oh my god. Frickin' mirror mode. Oh! No! Oh! You know what? I'm not gonna blame you guys for trying to tell me how to get mirror mode in the middle. Because ye gods, like, okay, what you showed me didn't work, but I wasn't paying attention, and now mirror mode is off, and now this pancake layer is like, frickin'... Okay, we're gonna park you for... I'm gonna watch this thing blow something up. Where's it?
Flip me.
We're gonna finish off with this thing shooting at a tear, because by gum, that's what I want to look at. Oh dear, just shoot at the tear, please. Like, guys, Alt-N does not... Okay. Tier, you wait for a hot second. Alright, build mode. Alt-N. Okay, what? Why did it work that time? Was I hitting the wrong button? Okay. There it worked. Great. Like, the reason I used control is driver is because people were telling me to use control as well. People were saying control, people were saying alt, people were saying shift. And no, Coco the cat, chat is not always right. Chat's been wrong frequently. So, sorry, getting salty. It doesn't, no, alright, now the chat's saying, see, chat's wrong, so, here, this is N, this is Alt-N, there it goes, it's in the middle, so, yeah, we've learned something here today, thank goodness we've learned a thing, let's just blow something up. Chad is also wrong. Chad is wrong. Everybody's just wrong. Okay, I just want to see this thing pop one turret off the tier. Oh my goodness. Guys, I might need to take a break from the depths. I might need to do that. I'm feeling less than inspired. Yay! Zapped a turret in the head. Oh boy. Ugh. Come on, guys. One more cram shot that we follow. Yay! Bang! Well, that popped off two turrets, but how wide is the tier? The tier is also... very not wide. Okay, that's it. I'm done. I've gotta stop. I can feel my mind getting fuzzy. So yeah, okay, this chat... Ladies and gentlemen. the stream was a success. We made a thing with hidden weapons in it. So, yeah. Hidden weapons, yeah, I'm just gonna prefab. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna do this, and I'm gonna do... What else? Like, no, we need to see... Okay, before... And... What the hell's the lock-up? Hold still, lads. Get the seagulls out of here. There we go, and after. Yay, thumbnail!
Thumbnail! Okay. Oh boy.
Alright, so now, yep, we're done. We'll see you later. Thank you all so much for tuning into the stream. It has been fun. Okay. Mirror mode. We, like, positive side, we made a hidden weapons turret. We learned about the Alt-N shortcut, which I didn't know about before. Chat only lied to me slightly. And a good time was had by all. So yeah, thank you all so much for watching. Follow me on Twitch, follow me on YouTube, support me on the Patreon and the YouTube membership and all that stuff. Thank you to all my current supporters, and I'll see you next time in the next stream. I don't know what that's going to be yet. If you have suggestions, let me know. Bye!